Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Microwave Engineering. In today's lab, we are going to learn about reflex klystron characteristics. Okay, so coming to the aim. So aim is to study the characteristics of a reflex klystron. And coming to the apparatus, we need a klystron power supply, reflex klystron gun, isolator, attenuator, slotted line, detector mount, CRO, and connecting probes to connect the CRO and the detector mount. Okay, and coming to the procedure, make the connections as per the block diagram. I will be showing the block diagram, and switch on the klystron power supply. So after switching on the klystron power supply, we need to set the knob to AM in the klystron power supply. We'll be having a modulator selector, in that we need to set the knob to AM in klystron power supply. Modulated amplitude and modulated frequency knob should be in the middle position, such that we can provide a good amount of amplitude and frequency to the microwave signal. Okay, so rippler voltage should be always maximum, that such that it will be in a negative voltage mode. Okay, initially beam voltage is at 235 volts, and we need to maintain the beam voltage between 235 volts to 300 volts. Okay, so we will be rotating the beam voltage knob such that around 275 volts. Okay, such that it will be maintaining an voltage between 235 to 300 volts. Slowly we will be moving the rippler voltage knob, and we will calculate the starting position of the signal in the CRO, and after obtaining the maximum signal, we will be taking that amplitude as well as the divisions, volts per divisions readings, and we will also calculate where the signal is falling. The fall of the signal is also considered. So starting of the signal, maximum signal reading, and the fall of the signal reading will be considered, and it will be considered as modes. Like that, we need to consider three modes: mode 1, mode 2, and mode 3. In each mode, we will be considering the starting reading of a signal, maximum signal reading, and the fall of the signal reading. We will be considering it in each mode. I will show you practically how to calculate all these modes. So similarly, we will be recording at least three modes with respect to the rippler voltage. As we are moving the rippler voltage, we will be calculating three modes: starting of the signal, the maximum signal what we obtained, and the fall of the signal. All these three readings will be included in each and every mode. Okay, like that, we will be considering at least three modes. Okay, from that we will be calculating the power, and we will be plotting the graph. So after plotting the graph, we need to write the result like: the characteristics of a reflex klystron oscillator has been studied. Okay, and coming to the block diagram, so my bench setup has got these blocks. We have a klystron power supply, reflex klystron, isolator, attenuator, slotted line, detector mount, and CRO. Okay, this is the block diagram of my experiment. Okay, and coming to the expected graph, after calculating the modes, okay, and after calculating the power with respect to the rippler voltage, we will be getting a waveform similar to like this. So for each mode, we will be getting one wave. Okay, so whatever the values we get, we need to draw the wave according to the rippler voltage and the power. Let's see the practical implementation of reflex klystron characteristics. To implement the reflex klystron characteristics, we require klystron power supply, microwave bench setup, and a CRO connected with a CRO probe. Okay, so we have a klystron power supply, okay, connected to a klystron mount. So this is the klystron oscillator or an amplifier which is used for generating microwave signals throughout this rectangular waveguide. Okay, this is getting cooled by a fan over there, okay, to avoid overheat. And this klystron mount is connected to an isolator, followed by variable attenuator. This slotted line is connected to a detector mount, and the detector mount is connected to a CRO through a CRO probe. Okay, now coming to the operation of klystron power supply, this modulation selection knob should be always in AM mode. Beam voltage should be in the minimum position, that is between Initially, it will be around 235 volts, but we need to maintain a voltage between 235 to 300 volts. And coming to the reflector voltage, it should be always maximum, that is in the negative mode. As we are using amplitude modulation mode, the amplitude modulation amplitude as well as frequency knob should be adjusted in such a way that we get a good amount of amplitude as well as frequency. Okay, let's switch it on. So if this knob is in the beam voltage, the voltage what we see here is in beam voltage. So initially the voltage is around 239 volts. We need to adjust the beam voltage such that it will be around between 235 to 300 volts. Okay, so I will be adjusting the beam voltage to around 275 volts. And coming to the, if you see the current is slowly getting increased. So it will be around 20 amperes of current. And coming to the reflector voltage, okay, so reflector voltage, as it is maximum and it is in negative mode, it will be showing around 245 volts. Okay, so we need to adjust this reflector voltage initially such that we will get a good waveform on the CL. Okay, now as we have already seen, the AM knobs, amplitude and frequency knob, should be in the middle position as well. Okay, now let's switch on the CRO. Okay, we can see a straight line over there. Okay, let's adjust the reflector voltage such that we get a proper signal initial. Okay, so I will be adjusting the reflector voltage from here. Okay, such that we will observe a proper signal over there. See, we got a signal over there. So somewhere around 99 volts or 100 volts, we are getting a first signal. Okay, now let's see how to produce reflex klystron characteristics. Okay, so whenever we are altering this particular reflector voltage knob, okay, we can see the changes of signal over there. So what we need to do is we need to keep on changing the reflector voltage knob such that whenever the signal is about to start, so this is the point where signal is about to start, we need to record that particular voltage, reflector voltage reading, and after when we get the required signal, okay, again we need to rotate the reflector knob. And after when we achieve a particular signal, we need to calculate the amplitude of that particular signal with respect to the volts per division reading. Okay, again we will be rotating the reflector knob till we lose the signal. Okay, so we have lost that signal. At what reflector voltage we have lost the signal, that will be our another reading. So we will be, as we are rotating this reflector voltage, we will be calculating the starting point of the signal. After getting the perfect signal, we will be calculating amplitude of the signal along with volts per division. And after losing the signal, okay, we will be calculating at what reflector voltage we are losing the signal. So first reading is starting of the signal, second reading is after getting the signal, we will be calculating amplitude as well as volts per division, and the third reading is after losing the signal. Like this starting point, after getting the signal, the ending point of the signal, these three readings will be considered as mode 1. Like that, we keep on rotating the reflector voltage and we will be taking three modes. So three waveforms starting points, three waveforms amplitude as well as volts per division, and three waveforms end points we will be considering, and according to the readings we will be plotting the graph. So we have a tabular column. So the first one is mode, the next one is the reflector voltage, and the third one is the amplitude into divisions per volts, and this value we will be converting it to power in the last. Okay, now let's switch on the Klystron power supply. Now let's write down the readings of mode 1. So in mode 1 we will be calculating starting of the signal. After getting the signal, amplitude and the divisions per volts or volts per division, as well as we will be calculating the ending of the signal. Okay, now at 99 volts I'm getting a signal. Okay, so somewhere around 99. So I will adjust this rippler voltage such that I will lose my signal, I will go to the starting point of the signal. So now this is the starting point of my signal. Now at 105 volts, so rippler voltage at 105 volts, okay, the signal is zero. Okay, so volts is zero and obviously power will be zero. Okay, now I will alter this reflector voltage such that I will get a signal. See, at a point I got a perfect signal. So around 100 volts I got a signal. Now in mode 1 only, as the rippler voltage is 100 volts, okay, my waveform readings are 1, 2, 3, 3.2, T.4. Okay, so around 3.4 into volts per division reading, let us see, 50. Okay, 50 millivolts. Let's calculate the power later. Okay, so at 100 volts we are getting this value. Now I will again move the reflector voltage such that I will get the end of my signal. Okay, so I am rotating the reflector voltage knob. See, I lost the signal. Okay, so at 97 volts I have seen the end of the signal. Okay, so at 97 volts, okay, I got end peak of the signal. This is mode 1. Okay, now let's see mode 2. Okay, now as I keep on moving this one, yeah, so I got a second signal. Let's see the starting point of this signal. See, so around 96 volts I got starting point of my signal. Okay, let's move the reflector voltage. See, so at 93 volts I got my second signal. Okay, so at 93 volts I got a second signal with an amplitude 1, 2, 3, 3.2, 3.4 and around 3.5. okay, at 93 volts I got 3.5 into 50 millivolts. Okay, so volts per division. Okay, now at which voltage I will lose the signal, let us see. So I am again moving the reflector voltage. See, I have lost the signal. Okay, so at around 86 volts I lost the signal. So at around 86 volts I got. I lost the signal, 0, 0. This is mode 2, okay? Now let's see mode 3. Okay, now I will again move the reflector voltage such that at what voltage we will get the starting point of the signal, let's see. Okay, I am moving the reflector voltage now, see. So this is the starting point, so around 65 volts, okay, I got the starting point of my signal, okay, which is 0, 0. Okay, now let's see my signal when I am moving this reflector voltage. See, I got a signal. So at 60 volts I got the signal. So this signal is 2.6, somewhere around 2.6, okay, 2.7, okay. So we have got 2.7 into 50 millivolts, so volts per division, 50, okay. So let's see the ending point. So at what voltage I will lose the signal, let's see. See, I have lost the signal, okay. So at 57 volts, I have lost the signal, that is my end point of my signal. So at 57 volts, I have lost the signal, 0, 0, okay. So if you see here, in mode 1 at 105 volts, starting of my signal was there. At 100 volts I got a signal with 3.4 into 50 millivolts. At 97 I again lost the signal. In mode 2 at 96 volts, my starting point of a signal was there. At 93 volts, I got a signal with 3.5 into 50 millivolts of amplitude, and at 86 volts I again lost the signal, okay. Let's see mode 3. At 65 volts there was a starting point of my signal. At 60 volts I have gotten 2.7 into 50 millivolts amplitude of a signal, and at 57 volts I have again lost the signal, okay. This is how to calculate minimum 3 modes, okay. So let's calculate the power of each and every mode value which we got, and using this power as well as Rippler voltage reading, let's plot the graph. So for the first mode, if you multiply this one, we will be getting around 170 millivolts, okay. So we have a formula, power equal to V square by R. So let's the resistance be 1 ohm, okay, initially. So the value will be 1, which it can be negligible. So P equal to V square by 1. So whatever the value we get in this particular 3 modes, okay, we need to double that value where we can get the value of power, okay. So from the mode 1, we have 170 millivolts. If you square this, okay, we will be getting around 289 into 10 square, which can be 28.9 millivolts, okay. So from mode 2, if you multiply this, we will be getting around 175 millivolts. If you double this value, we will be getting around 306 into 10 square, where we can make it as 30.6 millivolts, okay. So in the third mode, after calculating this, we will be getting around 135 millivolts, and if you double this, we will be getting around 182 into 10 square, which can be 18.2 millivolts. So these are the power values and these are the Rippler voltage values. So based on this, we are going to plot the graph.